Right. Judea, Black, Shalom L'Chaim, purified drink of water, the God that is out there. Shout out to the 12 tribes, support the people, not the cause, man. A couple things today. I know we just got through with the right fields. I did the little right field explainer, you know, like the left fields. Like, I got a couple left fields in here, too. But it's just one or two, maybe three. So today, this is what we're finna do. We're about to get into some wild. We're about to run it all up. Run it all the way up there. So, Judea Black, Shalom L'Chaim, purified water. They got it. It's up there. I got it. It's right here. Shout out to the 12 tribe. Remember we was talking about the secret? You get one of these? You get this? You know, you're gonna get the world's best kept secret? The world's best kept secret? Yeah, that's inside the pass along. Just inside of the pass along. So, we read that. Took it sent out after reading everything. It then passed along the package, which would have had that in there to the next person, and you would have an incense to remind you that you've read the secret. But anyway, speaking of that, let's get into some things today. So, back to this support the people, not the cause, man. Stand for Israel, stand for Palestine, stand for Palestine, stand for Israel. That whole little shebang and all of those, all those together is what I mean. I guess a better explanation would help. What I mean by this is, I support Israel because of the people, right? I see it like they was treated like African Americans, but they got their 40 acres and a mule, and their mule was somebody else's. But if you ask me, down somewhere in the right field, it kind of happened to blacks too. So, I stand for Palestine because of the people, not because of the cause, but because of the acres and the mule. You know, this is deeper than me. It's deep in the rap. I can't make this shit up. How people are fighting over this shit, and they have been. But anyway, I stand for the people, not the cause. Like the ceasefire, we needed the ceasefire so they could stop firing on all these innocent people, and they're trying to find a way and still out in limbo. And, you know, which creates some kind of epic diaspora for them in some kind of way. You know, some common diaspora, you know, which makes things legal somehow and away from everything that's built. But anyway, I support the people, not the cause, man. I shouldn't have to explain anything other than that. If you get it, you do. If you don't, then don't. I mean, shit is deeper than blue sea. So anyway, we're going to get into these next videos. Today I decided to bring you who were Hebrews, black Hebrews, because remember, if you got the pass along and you received the world's best kept secret, then this is what this is about. This is about that. I'm not here to convert to, I'm not here to do anything extra, but we're about to get right into this next video. So today we're getting into a few things, and we're going to start with the black Hebrews. Did Black Shalom L'Chaim, purified drink of water, they got us out there. Shouts out to the 12 tribes and I. Cue that music I like.
Oh, it doesn't seem right. I was born white, and my parents don't fight. They just told me they love me even nights. I don't lose sleep for kids sewing my sheets. One stitch in my sneaks, huh. As long as I can buy them both cheap.
Untangle the complex threads of relationship between those who identify as Black Hebrews or Black Israelites and those who identify as Jews. You probably learned little to nothing about the Jews of Africa, who predate the Jews of Europe by as much as 2,500 years. So let's start with a crash course in global Jewish history. It spans 4,000 years and is very involved, so I'm going to focus on the period relevant to this issue and break it down into a few. First of all, who are the Jews and how did we get our name? Over the millennia, several nations and empires invaded and occupied the ancient kingdom of Israel, including the Assyrians, the Babylonians, and the Romans. Jews got our name, Jews, from the Babylonian invasion of the southern region of ancient Israel, which was called Yehuda. In English, it's known as Judah. The people of Yehuda were the Yehudim, which in English is Jews. Yehuda, Yehudim. Judah, Jews. They were taken as captives to Babylon, which today is the land of Iraq. The Persians, who are the ancestors of the Iranians, conquered the Babylonians 50 years later. Persian King Cyrus offered the Jews religious freedom if they chose to stay in the Persian Empire. Many Jews did choose to stay, including my direct ancestors. Others returned to Israel to rebuild the motherland. King Cyrus not only allowed the Jews to return, but financed the rebuilding of Israel, in particular the Beth Hamikdash, the Holy Temple in Jerusalem, which in English is known as Jerusalem. The Jews who stayed in Persia either remained right where the Babylonians had left them, or they migrated through the vast Persian Empire throughout West, Central, South, and East Asia. For those of you who are not aware, West Asia is more commonly known as the Middle East. My family was among those who remained on the rivers of Babylon, which is not only a Bob Marley song, but an actual place where the Jews were exiled, between the Tigris and Euphrates River. They remained on that land for the next 2,600 years until they were forced to flee as refugees from Iraq in 1950.